so cool. Yes. We're called Bane from Massachusetts, USA. This is our first time ever here in Costa Rica. Thank you guys so much for coming out, man. This means the world to us to be here and to play songs for you guys. We're gonna have some fun? Yeah? Gonna do some dances? I don't know, I can't speak Spanish and I don't know if you can understand my English, but I'm gonna try to talk a little bit about the songs anyway. Maybe you'll get it. This next song is about not being afraid to take risks in your life. Not living this life where you're just totally sheltered and safe and afraid to go out and try new things because you don't want to fail, because you don't want to look silly in front of your friends, so you never do anything. And I think that's sort of a sad way to live. This life is about adventure. This life is about pushing yourself. This song's called Annie Up. Thank you. We'll be here tomorrow. bunch of songs that we didn't get to play tonight. We can't do everything tonight, but every song we do know how to play, we'll play within the next 2 days, for sure. And also, tomorrow, Soul Control will play Give It Up! Give It Up! Great band from back home, Poor Bastards, all their merchandise got taken away from them yesterday at customs. So I don't know if they're gonna have any t-shirts for you, but it would mean the world to them if you guys really gave them everything you had tomorrow. Dance your fucking asses off, sing like it's the last show you're ever gonna see. They're far, far from home right now. These next few songs goes out to those guys. It means a lot to us if they came out today to hang out. Wish them luck on their whole tour here in Central America.
No!
have fun? You had fun? I hope so.
We really didn't know what to expect. We'd never been here before, and the shows were really, really fun. Kids were really warm and nice and seemed excited to have us here, so that's all we ever asked for, you know? It was really, really fun. We didn't know what to expect, but this seems really, really nice here. Kids seem to really care about each other, and it just seems to be a good feeling of like family and community here that you don't get where we come from. And really, it's just because hardcore is just like this living, breathing thing that goes through different phases and is ever-changing, and it really depends on what size of hardcore you want to concentrate on, what you want to focus on. If you want to notice the negative, then there's plenty of that. If you want to notice the positive and the beautiful, there's plenty of that all over the place, you know? It's just always changing, always going through different phases and good times and bad times, and you just have to ride it out, you know? Right now seems to be a very good time in hardcore. It's changed my life in every single way. I mean, it gave me an outlet for all of my anger and confusion and frustration, and has made me understand music on a deeper level. And when we get home, we're gonna write new songs for all winter. Well, they'll write music together, and we'll just get together for rehearsals and just start writing songs. And then I'll add lyrics when it's over. Nothing too soon, but we're gonna tour next year for sure. After we write new songs, we'll do some touring.
This next song is about standing for something in your life. It's about really living your life like a punk fucking rocker, where you believe in something, where you believe that this world should be better, where you're upset about the things you see around you. You don't just go through life swallowing whatever they feed you, but you demand a better world, and you're pissed, and you're rebellious, and you spray paint on walls, and you fucking get a crazy haircut to piss your parents off, and you spend your Friday nights in rooms like this, screaming and dancing and sweating, because this is what makes sense. So it's for everybody in this room who's fighting for something. I don't care what it is. Who's that?